ఓం ఆత్మా ఓం ఇత్యాకాక్షం సర్వం యద్భూతం యచ్చభవ్యం. ఓం ఈస్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ బ్రహ్మన్ అండ్ దట్ ఓం ఈస్ బ్రహ్మన్ ఐ నర్సెస్. సో ది ఎంటైర్ అండర్స్టాండింగ్ అన్లెస్ యూ కన్వర్ట్ టు ఐ యూ కెనాట్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ది ఉపనిషత్స్. ఓకే బట్ రియల్ ఐ. ఓకే సో ఓం నమ శివ ఓం నమ శివాయ. ఓం ఇస్ ఐ ఆర్ బ్రహ్మన్ న మా శివాయ. ఫైవ్ మంత్రాస్ అదే న మా శివాయ. సో న స్టాండ్స్ ఫర్ ఎర్త్, మ స్టాండ్స్ ఫర్ వాటర్, షి స్టాండ్స్ ఫర్ ఫైర్, వా స్టాండ్స్ ఫర్ వాయు ఐ, అండ్ యా స్టాండ్స్ ఫర్ స్పేస్. రైట్ ఫైవ్. ఓకే సో ఇస్ దర్ ఫైవ్ ఫైవ్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ అవుట్ దేర్? దే ఆర్ నాట్ దేర్. The five elements are not there. There's existence there. Okay? And existing is appearing as five elements because of five senses. So that's why Om Nama Shivaya. Na stands for touch, smell, taste, form, sound. Five. Touch, smell, sound and taste are these five blind men element, five blind men making existence appear as a world. They are making the existence appear as body. The five blind men are trying to figure out what the hell is there. So they are making the existence appear as the world. They are making existence appear as body. Okay. So then, whom they are reporting to? Mind. So for that mind, you have to tell Shivoham. First, resolve outer. Then, Shivoham, I am Shiva, I am pure consciousness, existence, bliss, infinite, like that is Om Namah Shivaya. Right? So first let us chant Om Namah Shivaya. For the five elements, all there are there. Now the elements are not there, existence is there. Om is Brahman. Okay? Which is means I. Na ma shivaya represents panchabhutas, five elements, space, earth, water, five elements. Now the five elements are there because of five sensations, five tanmatras, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. Are there five elements? There is existence. Existence is superimposed by five sensations. Okay, now for whom is sensation? For me. Who is me? Shivoham. Me also is not there. There's I.
So when you say Om Namah Shivaya, you are actually concentrating on that existence for which all this is the outer. I is the inner
outer. That's how that Om Namah Shivaya mantra came. Right? When it's not mechanical chanting Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. Artha aitha nimge? Yen artha aitha nimge? Nodana, you olle udi heli. Here I explain madi. Adu correct artha aitha heli.
ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನ್
ಶಿವ ನಾನು ಫೈವ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇದಾವ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಅದು ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಶಿವ ಶಿವ ಒಂದು ಇದೆ ಆಯ್ತಾ ಆ ಫೈವ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಯಾಕಿದೆ ಈ ಐದು ಜನ ಇದಾರಲ್ಲ ಕಣ್ಣು ಕಿವಿ ಮೂಗು ಬಾಯಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಸೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಓಂ ನಮ ಶಿವಾಯ ಅಗೈನ್ ಪಂಚೇಂದ್ರಿಯಗಳು ಅದು ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತದೆ ಫಾರ್ ಹೂಮ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ನನಗೆ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ನನಗೆ ಜೀವ ಅದು ನಾನು ಕೂಡ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಶಿವೋಹಂ ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಿದೆ ಒಟ್ಟು ಶಿವ ಮಾತ್ರ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ತಪ್ಪ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ನಿಮಗೆ ನೋಡಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಏನು ಹೇಳಿದೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತು ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನ್ ಮತ್ತು ನಾನು ಒಂದೇ ಎರಡು ಒಂದೇ ಶುದ್ಧ ನಾನು
ನಮ ಶಿವಾಯ ಪಂಚಭೂತ ವೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅಸ್ like
as means whom
changing
and
that is not existed
changing I is actually coming from
shiva
so shiva is only real
is shiva
is real so again and again only shiva is there so if I and you are there there is a trouble actually shiva only is reality that's called advaita which is I. Okay. Shall we chant? Now think of earth, entire infinite earth. Earth is actually existence, existence aspect of earth. Earth exists everywhere.
All matter.
All matter. Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Think of matter everywhere. This earth, sun, moon, everywhere the matter is there. Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Now think of water, which is flowing. Anything flowing anywhere in the universe. Om Namah Shivaya.
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 Shivaya Namah Om.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Now fire, everywhere light is there. Sun has light, stars have light, everywhere the universe light is there. That is actually Shiva principle, means existence. Om Namah Shivaya.
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 Shivaya Namah Om.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Om Namah Shivaya.
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 Shivaya Namah Om.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Now we are speaking of wind element, blowing, moving, everything what moves actually. Wind is not just one element, everything in the universe is moving, moving, moving. That's Shiva. Om Namah Shivaya.
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 Shivaya Namah Om.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Now the space element where there is nothing is called space. That is appearing. Space exists. Om Namah Shivaya.
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 Shivaya Namah Om.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Now come to the body. Body exists. Om Namah Shivaya.
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 Shivaya Namah Om.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Now come to the water element in the body, which is blood. Everything which is flowing in the body is blood. That is Shiva. Existence appeared to be flowing. Om Namah Shivaya.
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 Shivaya Namah Om.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Now come to the fire element in the body, which is heat. Om Namah Shivaya.
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 Shivaya Namah Om.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Now the air element, the breathe air we breathe in and breathe out through the lungs and energy movement in the body is air element. Om Namah Shivaya.
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 Shivaya Namah Om.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Now come to the space element. There is a space inside our body throughout. So that space element is form of Shiva. Om Namah Shivaya.
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 Shivaya Namah Om.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Now who is talking about this? I am talking, and I is actually changing I. So for the changing I have to tell, really what is there is Shiva, awareness. Shivoham.
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 Sit silently. Asatoma
Asatoma
Sadgamaya
Sadgamaya
Tamasoma
Tamasoma
Chasat Jyotirgamaya
Jyotirgamaya
Mrityorma
Mrityorma
Amritam Gamaya
Amritam Gamaya
Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi
Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi
Lokaha samastaha
Lokaha samastaha
Sukhino bhavantu
Sukhino bhavantu
Lokaha samastaha
Lokaha samastaha
Sukhino bhavantu
Sukhino bhavantu
Harihi Om
Harihi Om
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha
Harihi Om
Harihi Om
So this is the way the mantra, any mantra has been chanted. Understanding God is all pervading in the form of existence, in the form of consciousness, and God is infinite. So if you chant mantra without understanding the nature of reality, your mind will become, mind will not still expand. It will be narrow. So now let us understand the difference between belief and reality. What is the difference between belief and reality? There is something called belief, and this one is okay?
No, I just
want to
understand.
Okay. So, what is the difference between belief and reality?
That is an opinion and others.
Belief is a concept or a story. Reality is
mindset belief.
So belief is a repeated thought. So repeatedly, if you are told that you are a woman, so that is stored in your memory, and that thought comes, I am a woman. That's called belief. So now tell me, what is belief in your life and what is reality in your life? Can you separate out and tell me?
Everything is belief.
Lots of beliefs.
No. I is the reality, belief is the story.
Okay, I mean before coming to the
class. Before coming to the class. So the world runs on belief as reality and reality as belief. Believe in God, they say, which is God is reality. They say believe in God, which is reality. Reality you have to believe, and unreality you have to, unreality is reality for you. The ways of the world are ulta. They say believe in God. Okay, the world is real. Actually, world is a belief. God is only real. So it's completely opposite. Everything what you know is belief only, program only. So, can you believe your senses? Your senses are showing only small window, through small window the world is shown. Seeing is believing, we say. What seeing is believing? Can you know anything outside in the world? Is there something you can know? You cannot know, because whatever your small five holes are there. And a mind is sitting and is trying to tell you what the hell is there. With that, what you can know? I mean, that doesn't mean that it's not useful, okay? I'm not questioning the usefulness. We're only speaking of the reality. God is reality, I am that reality, it only makes me peaceful. Everything else is a maya, appearance. Clear? Divya? Any questions? So, there is a world outside there. Something outside there, okay? World, a big world, infinite world. And I am seeing through my sense organs, the reality outside there. First of all, I can't even sense, I can get some small fraction of what is there. I can't get full picture. So that I start have to believe, no? Believe, no? Something is out there. And my entire life I have to run based on that. The entire life of ours is a storyline based on some belief stories. Right? So now you try to verify the belief. Some beliefs are false. Okay, false belief you start this thing. So that's the error. And right belief, you have to evaluate. Right? So now how do you evaluate this? What is the entire belief system, what is there? How do you evaluate? The entire life you are living on based on the belief systems. That's a society program. How do you evaluate that? How do you judge what is right or wrong?
Intellect will help.
Intellect, how you can help? Intellect is also a part of that whole storyline. So only thing which you require for weighing, you need something of teaching of Vedanta. Here it's Vedanta says, you are not what you think. Tattvamasi. So against that you have to evaluate.
And the whole storyline falls.
Storyline falls. That is called Atmadarshana. Otherwise you are living in a whole right knowledge, wrong knowledge, both are problems. You need some gold standard for verifying, no? Now where will you bring? In this whole story, where will you bring? That's why I said, okay, Vedanta can give you a way out. That too, not many things in Vedanta. Tattvamasi, Aham Brahmasmi. I have taught you this, all these things, four Vedanta Vakyas?
Yeah.
Have I?
No.
Mahavakya teaching I have done? Class I have done?
No.
Huh?
No.
So I'll do the Mahavakya class. Please remind me later. So these four Mahavakyas can save you. To evaluate what is real, what is unreal. Otherwise, you don't have a reference also. Okay. So how do you do that? The Guru will take these four Mahavakyas and put various what you call yukti, technique, teaching, and try to bring clarity to you. That's all is done. what is a belief actually? Belief is a filler, a gap filler. Filler, where you don't have this something, you fill that with that. Right? Is your body very solid? Do you have a solid body?
No.
Huh? You have a solid body as long as you believe that it's a solid body. If you start observing the body very, very thoroughly, up and down, constantly with your sharpened this thing, you find that there's no body. The body is a myth in the mind. So is the world. Okay, I have made you, I mean, without going through very complicated this thing, Jagrata Miss Jagrata Miss Swapna Miss Sushupti Prakriya, I told how your mind fools you into believing that the world is real. The world appears, disappears. Body appears, disappears. Then still you say, I am the body. Still you are worried about the good condition and bad condition of the body. Okay. So, belief and reality. Is time real?
No.
Time is also a perception. Shadi, is time real? You have a watch, no? Is it real or not real? I mean, it's duplicate watch. Why time is not real? It's relative. When you are with your friends, so many days are over. I didn't even realize it goes like a no time. Okay? You have a toothache just after you slept at 9 o'clock in the night. Morning you have to go to doctor. 9:05. What is the time? Still not 5 o'clock. Oh, 9:05, 9:06. every moment appears to be fine. Yeah. Stretching. So time goes fast or slow, depending on your mental state. So now is it real?
No.
Huh? Then what is this time about? All this thing time about Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Huh? What is this Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday and all this time?
Clock time.
They are all called clock time. Done for your convenience, but that doesn't make time real.
We have to function.
Who is we?
Little life.
For their functioning, some convenience is given. But don't start believing that it's real. Time is not real. Okay? Time is also a concept. You know why? So now, how do you get a sense of time? Between two events, there is a time. You saw one event, okay? Sunrise you saw, and sunset you saw, and you said time has passed. Right? Two events you saw. Right? So two events is two thoughts. I saw sunrise, and I saw sunset. Correct? So gap between these two, you call as sunset, time. So what is the fallacy in this? What is the falsehood in this? Error in this?
The first was
the
story, second was
the
story.
The second is right now you are experiencing sunset. But you are remembering sunrise. Remembering, which is memory. Memory is not real, memory is past. Is past not real? Have anybody seen, any of you seen past?
In memory, it's only present.
When you see past, always it's present. Okay? Have you seen future?
No.
Future is also present. So, any experience of past or future is present. In present only it can happen. So, is there a past or present?
No.
Future. The past and future are your memory. Memory, why it's not real, we have already discussed. So is there a passage of time?
Timeless.
From the awareness point of view, I am timeless. Thoughts appear in me and give an illusion of time. That's why in sleep, you slept for 4 hours. You don't know the time is there because there is no thought. Thoughts create the time. No thought? No time. Right? Is there space? What is the distance between earth and sun? Can anybody tell? 15 million?
150 million
kilometers. 150 million kilometers. How many people agree with this? So where is the sun? 150 million kilometers away? When you see the sun, where is the sun? Is it, sun is there or in your eyes?
Eyes.
Is sun there in your eyes or in your brain? Image of sun is in your brain. Is sun your image of brain, in the brain or in the mind?
Poor people, they have traveled, no, Guruji, and get
in the mind. Is it in the mind or is it in consciousness? So where is the time, where is the space and time? Where is the distance between the sun and you?
Inside, there is no distance.
Inside me means what?
Inside the consciousness. I am the conscious.
There's not inside also. Inside. In conscious, there's no inside outside also. So this again, appearance in consciousness. The best example for that, I know yesterday you had a dream, very nice dream. She had a dream, I know the dream. Okay, in the dream, she went to Paris. She went to Eiffel Tower. Okay, she had what? Pizza. Right? And you came back. Air France travel. Where was Paris?
Huh?
Where was the dream?
No mind.
Where was the mind?
Within
consciousness. Huh? So everything happened in the mind and mind was in consciousness. And after waking up, you said there was no Paris also. Same way, this world also is not there. Everything appears in consciousness and disappears. This you have to understand in the waking state. That's what is called meditation. Waking state, your mind has to become silent. Then you understand, okay, world is not there. Then you are mukta. That's all. How do you make my mind silent? By jnana, you make clarify all doubts. Then sit silently. Nothing. Over. Matter's over.
Then why is everything happening?
Do you go to movies?
Yeah.
Huh? Why do you want to go to movies?
Entertainment.
For you, entertainment, you can go to movie and TV. For Brahman, what is entertainment?
We are the Brahmans.
We hate the movies.
Huh?
We are the Brahmans.
Ah, that's
for
you.
Us, it is entertainment.
Ah.
We are the entertainers.
Yes, but whatever is he bringing, some actors he will bring somewhere. There are no actors, no. You only have to create actors. When you say we, again you are bringing the body and mind, no, consciousness. You are, in consciousness, the millions of bodies are created. Each of them are appearing from Brahman. Okay, not as you as a body and mind. Body and mind, you are small. So for that consciousness, there is no time, there is no space. Some of you should do time pass. So create the time. For you time pass, you have to time is there, you have to how to pass the time. For him there is no time, there is a pass. Time has to be passed. So what is the purpose of this thing? It's entertainment. That's why it's called Shiva Leela. Kidira? Vishnu Maya, Vishnu Leela. Entertainment program for Vishnu and Shiva. Are you clear? Understand? So now I'll tell you. Your question was, what is the question? Huh? What is fate? So, there is something called past, there is something called future. Right? Is it real?
No.
Is past and future real?
No.
Only I is real. Right? So living in the present moment is also false. So now the time and space you can think like this. Okay? What is this thing? This is now. Right? This is now, this plane. There is a space and time. Right? So every time you can experience only in the now. The now is a point. Now is a point in the
space and time.
Space and time is in now. Right? So there's infinite possibilities here. You can take one point and be aware of that. Attention. Okay? So this infinite possibility is all that is possible. Everything possible is there now. Everything is now only, no? Your future is also now only, no? Your past is also now only, no? So that means everything which can happen in the past, present and future is in now. But why I am experiencing this now? Because your attention is, your sakshi is observing only one point here. Right? So now, you start worrying. What will happen to me in future? What will happen to me in future? Okay? Understand? What you are doing? What will happen to me in future? Who will take care of me? How the life will be in my future? Now, where is your attention? Attention is now. Your mind you have shifted to future. But always both are in the now only. So now what you have done? Instead of this point, you have picked up some other point in this plane. Right? So what you have done? You are activating another point of your point of view in this plane. Now, everything exists in past, present and future is in now only. It comes never past. So tell me something happened in the past, you tell me. I mean just tell me something. You tell me now. What happened in something, some event happened in the past, tell me. Give me an example. You tell some place you have gone, some study, anything, what you want, any event. I don't have to.
I went to a concert.
You went to the concert, how many years back?
1 month back.
1 month back, I went to concert. So that you are remembering in the now. So you have shifted your point of reference, point of observation in this now plane, where the past also. When you went to the concert, was it now for you? No, not now. The concept, when you experience the concept in the present only. Right? Can you experience something in the past? As a memory, you can. So now that memory you brought to the present. So that means, memory also came to the present. It can experience only in the present only. The past and present and future are in the
present.
Now. There is nothing called future, there is nothing called past. So the moment you start thinking of something, you start shifting your point of reference to that. For example, you say, what will happen to my health? What will happen to my health? So then what you are saying, this point you are not comfortable. You shift in this point where the health is not good, because you are seeking that. You are actually shifting your attention to a point where there is nothing is good.
In future.
There is nothing in future, it is only present.
Then where am I shifting the point?
Shifting the point to the future actually.
What you call as future, you are bringing it to present. What will happen to me in future? Where are you bringing that?
In the
present.
Yeah.
Right? So in the it has never gone to future. Future you are thinking in the present. When future happens, it is in the present now.
Yeah.
You are thinking of the future, you are brought to the present. So the moment you are brought to the present, then what will happen? You are shifting from where you are to that point. Okay, if you are worried about the future, you go to a point where there is more worry.
This is not clear.
I am always here and now.
This is not clear.
I am always here and now. My mind may go to any point in the future or
no, no, no. When you say I am here and now, only about mind only. I am in here not referring to body. I am here and now is about the mind only. Mind is here and now. Okay, experience, all experience happens here and now only.
Experience so, is happening
here and now. Now you say, the present is not good enough for me. Good. What will happen to me? Future, will it be worse? So you're asking a question. In the present. So your mind has shifted to the future in the present.
So we become that one only then.
You are shifting to that. In the present. Because when you experience the future, also is in the present only. It's everything is happening in the present only. You are creating your future in the present. Actually, it's not creation. It's already, the multiple points are already, all possibilities are already available. So you are picking up one point, which is. So when I say I am here and now, it's referring to the mind, not for the body. So you can be here and now at this moment, experiencing what is happening, be with the experience, or you can shift your attention to a future point, so-called future point. What will happen to you in future? The moment you think of that, your mind has shifted to future. But the future has come to the present. The so-called present. Okay? So now...
No, the future has come to the present if I recognize that I am thinking of the past.
Okay? Huh? No. What I am saying is, right now there is no past. The future has come to you now. What will happen to me in future means future has come to you now. In the here and now. theoretically you are not in the here and now, you are in the future. But the future is not in the future, it's here and now again. So now you actually you started to press a button. This is where I ought to be, here and now, in the future. So when the future comes, you are there actually. Already you are initiated. This is what is called destiny, my dear. You understand? Too heavy, yeah?
But we think that maybe my health will go wrong. That is a thought. But what is that, you know, which happens to us, like for real?
See, first you have to understand, there is nothing called future or past in reality. Future and past is about thought only. Thoughts are giving illusion of past and future. So when the past happened, then it is also present. Now only it happened, right?
Yeah.
So 10 years back, I went to a movie. That time it was now only, no?
Yeah, thinking. Yeah.
No. Your experience always can happen only in the present moment, now only. Right? Can you see a movie in the past? To see a movie, to experience anything in life, you have to come to the present. Correct?
Yeah.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Now you say, I saw a movie 10 years back. Okay, you are recollecting that memory, you are bringing to the present. Correct? But when the experience happened, it was in the present only. Correct? No? So right now, at any point of time, we create a future also in the present. What I think of now will start creating my future in the present future. So what will happen to my health? Will it go bad? This is the thought in the present. Right? So now what will happen? You are starting a creation now, in the present. You have created a future now. And you experience the future also in the now.
How is that possible? You experience the future now.
Immediately.
Because for that,
say,
you are saying my health will go wrong now.
No. What will happen to my health
yeah.
in the future?
Yes.
Right? You have a concept of time.
Yeah.
But the thought has come to you in the present.
Yes.
Right? Is there something called future?
No.
So you start experiencing that sometime now.
Sometime now.
Sometime now, I have to tell the time, otherwise, how will I explain that?
Yes.
You are activating buttons, Ashtay. That's, I mean, you can imagine entire life of time and space is like a board, big board. So you press here 10 years back, you press here 9 years back, you press here 8 years back, but press all happens is now only.
Then everything is a point of memory and you are looking at a memory point which is marked as future for you.
Correct. it's a board where all points are time and space. Time and spot points, memory
coordinates.
So this is actually all, everything in your everything is there in this box, in the one plane only. Everything what is possible to happen, everything which is possible in your life is there in one plane. But which point you will go from where is what you choose at this moment.
Again, there is no control over thoughts. Again, we have to come back to awareness.
You have to come to now. What? Not clear?
Then
we
will be the creator.
We will
frame our own
decision. When you Brahma means what? You give response to somebody and you say, I am suffering, is it? It is not like that.
We will be the creator, but...
We means who?
Consciousness.
Brahman is the creator, no?
We are Brahman.
So everything is happening in your... You can only imagine like this. Everything happening to you, it's like a map is there.
But if we create bad, then we are creating our destiny to be bad.
Yeah, definitely. That's why they are saying no.
I alone exist and everything is just nothing but an appearance in my mind. So there is only I.
And the mind, everything appears is like actually everything is infinite possibility laid before you. Everything is possible. Okay, so it's like a, you can imagine it's a big map. Whatever is possible for you, it's all there in that one map. So one point is now. So another point is say, I want to be happy. That point, I want to be happy is there. So it starts moving there. No, I am suffering. It'll go here. And everything you are creating now. And when you experience it also is now. It's too heavy.
You had shared that. Paper and the holes.
What did I say? That hole in the paper, no?
Hole in the paper.
So, what? Is heavy?
Yeah.
So, just because I am Brahma, I can't escape responsibility. Okay, you can't tell Brahma, oh God, why did you create me and why did you create trouble for me? So, along with the understanding that I am Brahma, you take the responsibility also. Or, you are understanding or not understanding?
Heavy.
What is heavy? See, what I am saying is, at this moment we are creating our future. Whatever called future. If you start thinking of future as a negative, the negative future will be created. If you start thinking of future as positive, a positive future will be created. If you start thinking that I am Brahman at this moment, you are getting past and future. Every possibility is given in front of you. Actuality depends on what you think at that moment. No, I want to get one crore, 100 crore rupees, okay? I want to get 100 crore rupees, fine, okay? Why I didn't get, I wanted 100 crores, didn't get it. You will get 100 crores, sometime in some lifetime, it will definitely come.
Not
necessarily this lifetime. Because this lifetime, whatever has to be already happening, already pipeline. Whatever else, the pending items in this lifetime already have done. Now you are coming, I want 100 crores, okay, it will come in some lifetime. That's next item in the list.
So the karma is also a concept.
Obviously.
So the more you think it is karma, then...
What? It's becoming heavy. See, it is very simple. It means that your destiny is in your hands now. What happened till today, what we did earlier. So what you do now is what is your future.
Okay. Now, 1 hour later, I slip and fall. I'll get hurt. But I didn't think of it, right? That I'll fall.
You prepare for it. Right? So when you go and slip and fall, that thought has crossed in your mind sometime earlier, in time. That is manifested. Constantly we are creating our life as we go. Either consciously or unconsciously. Unconsciously when you create, we'll get into trouble. Consciously when we create, we'll become free. Consciously means I am consciousness, I am Brahman, I am the reality. With this understanding if you do, it'll become beautiful. Otherwise it'll become messy.
So dangerous
knowledge. So how do you collapse everything?
Who am I? Are you aware? There's no point actually. There's pointless. What is it? There is dimensionless. Am I aware? Awareness, there is no dimension. There is no time and space. So you go, the moment you go to awareness, you are free from time and space. The moment you come to time and space, you are bound. Then you start creating. Henry, clear? Yes, sir.
Basically, there is no control over anything except
awareness. You have to come back, then you have a control, means what you can do. Otherwise you are actually continuously rolling on based on what is happening.
So that also one thought should come. Okay,
correct. That's why you have come here, no? That's why you have come here, no? You have kept an alarm clock. When I get into too much of trouble in the office or home, I'll come to Atmadarshana class. That alarm is clipped. That's why you have come here. So this is also a part of that destiny which you have created earlier. Clear? Destiny is understood?
Yeah.
Destiny is what happens to you now. Okay? Now what you do today, now will create your future destiny. Doing today means doing action or thinking. Both create destiny tomorrow. But tomorrow also gets created now. Because that when you experience it tomorrow, it will become now only. Some things don't get experienced because I want $1 million or I want a top rank. It doesn't happen because so far you have created, that's in the pending in the list. That will happen in some lifetime because your lifetime is many. Are you clear, Andre?
How does Prabhuji, so in awareness you don't create?
No. Awareness you are decreating. Okay? So you are decreating. So you are taking a break from the time and space. So first to create something, you have to decreate. Otherwise you are continuously you are involved in the creation. So get out of the creation, then once you enter, you can recreate, you can change. Otherwise you are continuously in there.
Because the vasanas are there, which is from the subconscious, pushing you to
do that. Yes, sir.
Jnani has no thoughts, right?
Jnani has no unconscious thoughts. When it is required, he'll use it. He doesn't get used by the thoughts.
Yeah. So now if I have a thought, you say that we create the future. So if a jnani has any conscious thoughts, so he'll create whatever he wants.
Yeah. Thoughts are actually putting a point on this matrix. This is where I want to go. And the thoughts with the conscious thoughts are called intention or sankalpa. When you do right sankalpa, you will move into that point. Okay. So best thing is, I am awareness, you come back. So then you don't do unconsciously create. Unconscious creation is what lead to mess. Again and again.
So decreating is being in that awareness all the time.
Yes. Satchit. So let me make it simple. The creation is appearance. Okay, you will be in any point of time experiencing something in life. So you'll think of good about it, bad about it, and that will create your future point. And it's already momentum is there. You can't get out of momentum, right? You cannot suddenly change it because already you have started creating. So you have an option to come out of the creation. You can decreate. That means you cannot come out of time and space. Then you can become the awareness. So now you are decreating, you are not stuck in that momentum. So now when you enter now again in time and space, you have an ability to slightly change. Maybe momentum may not be too much different, but you can change the direction. Your conscious creation starts. So far you are into unconscious creation. Are you getting it? from unconscious creation to decreation to conscious creation. Advani starts teaching. So he is doing conscious creation now.
How do we get this motivation to do conscious creation? When we are in trouble, it will automatically
impact
all of us.
Why do you go to a dental doctor?
When we have any
toothache.
Yeah.
So the motivation comes from pain in life.
Until that pain comes,
or what? Until that pain comes, enjoy life. Then after that, the pain will come. Life, pain doesn't leave anybody in life. A small pain or big pain will keep coming. Pain is something guaranteed in life. Okay, nothing else is guaranteed.
So when random thoughts are coming, constantly become aware of Buddha Satchit.
Random thoughts are arising because you are not conscious.
Conscious.
The moment you're conscious, thoughts will not be there. Clear? Any sir? Any clear? Any doubt? So, what we are saying?
But a future thoughts, bagi yojane maadbeku anta a Buddha da ondo. Future thoughts.
So unconscious creation, meditation, jnana lead to conscious decreation. Decreation, it's called awareness. Now when you enter, you can start conscious creation. That was heavy. If you don't meditate, you'll continue what you are doing. Okay, meditation is breaking. I am not the body. Then none of the problems will affect you. If you constantly think I am the body, again you are creating more problems. Right? You have to come out of that. Then again come back. Meditation come back. So now what will happen? You are breaking from the problem. Otherwise your mind is constantly thinking of the same things. It's creating more.
The conscious creation could be always that I am Brahman, conscious creation.
Yeah, then you are not doing any work.
She has a doubt regarding this.
Because what is meant by pursuing the past? To pursue the past means to yourself to lose yourself. Yeah. What is saying? If you keep thinking of the past, you are lost in the past. Thoughts. If you keep thinking about the future, you are lost in the future. Right? But future is real? Not real. Past is real? Not real. But thinking about them, you are creating that future and past. Unreal, you are imagining and creating it. So instead of that, come to the present. So come to the present. From the present, you come to the presence. From presence, you come to pure eye. Then you are becoming free from this creation.
But future bage think madadre, I thought it was thinking about the future makes us to come out from the past.
No, it cannot, because let's give an example. So I was struggling in my life earlier. I will do well in my future. Okay, again constantly you are going to past and future, right? So that is required. Thinking about past is required. But brooding is not required. So about past you thought. So what are all the mistakes I did, what I learning I have, that you bring it to present. Okay, now what people do, no, they will not do that. They will keep on worrying, oh, I should not have happened like that, it should not happen. That's called worry thinking. Whereas conscious thinking is, okay, this mistake I did in past, this is the correction I have to do in future, you come to the present. So you are not worrying. You are bringing learning. Then you apply now, then you meditate, then you work on that, that will become real. Now, when you say people thinking about the future, there are people are worried about the future. That worry is speaking of. Not what I should do tomorrow. What I should do tomorrow is action. Oh, what will happen to me in future? That is called worry. Stop that. Come to the present. Go become meditative. Go to the self. then come back and start doing, there will be conscious creation. Now it's a beautiful creation. Otherwise, it's unconscious creation, which is based on the past momentum. That's called karma.
Talking too much unconsciously can create impression.
Talking, karma, thinking. Okay. It need not be just talk,
thought,
action.
Yeah, thought.
Should we close for the day?
Those unconscious thoughts only come.
Thoughts will come only when you are unaware. That's called unconscious. There is conscious thought. You are aware, you have become silent, then okay, let me do this.
Yeah.
Consciously. That's so coming.
The thought create the future, right?
Yeah. That is.
Then what role does karma have?
What role?
Does karma have? Because you do something with someone, I have to get it back.
Thought itself is karma. Thought itself translates into karma. Thought itself is vasana. Thoughts coming from vasana and that become karma. So that will be experience, then again it become vasana. So now you have to, whole effort is to become free from vasana, going back to pure awareness.
Live in the present.
Live in the present, not only live in the present. It's more than living in the present. Who am I? Awareness. Okay. Living in the present means you are still in the present moment. That's okay, that's required when you act in the world. But when you go back, you go to the presence, I am, and awareness, then be free. So any more questions? Can you close for the day? Jyot se jyot jagao,
jyot se jyot jagao,
sadguru jyot se jyot jagao,
sadguru jyot se jyot jagao, mera antar
timir mithao,
timir mithao,
sadguru jyot se jyot jagao,
sadguru jyot se jyot jagao,
he yogeshwar,
he yogeshwar,
he jnaneshwar,
he jnaneshwar,
he parameshwar,
he parameshwar,
he sarveshwar,
he sarveshwar.